just made it onto the plane to Limoges. I couldn't fit my things into my bag, so I'm having to wear my dressing gown as a coat. I added a scarf to make it look as though it was planned.
This must be the same as Egypt.
It is actually, Michael, very similar to Egypt, yes. My dressing gown and I have had to hit the ground running because, although I've just landed, in 3 days' time we have a huge 70th birthday party. We've rented the whole chateau at Lalande and we'll be doing all the catering for it. I've arrived home to find a focaccia baking competition going on in the newly restored bread oven.
Okay, so we've got two masterpieces here, which we've slaved over for literally 5 hours or something extraordinary. And it's got some incredible herbs. We're looking at thyme and rosemary and virgin olive oil.
Okay,
let's see. I think it needs
10 more minutes.
10 minutes.
Let's put them moving both close to the fire.
Okay.
Do circles around each other.
Okay, yeah.
Muddle it up so no one will know which one's which.
Oh, wow.
Looks-wise, I quite like the look of this one.
You haven't tasted it yet!
This is the winning focaccia.
She might have made the best one.
Marie, what the hell are you thinking?
I mean, I know I wanted a biscuit, but are you trying to get me fat?
It's beautiful.
You like it?
Yes, I love it.
That's going to look so pretty on you.
Yeah, I love the colour. I think I'll fit it really well.
Is that how you're going to be walking around in it?
Yeah.
Wow, we could not have asked for a better day for a party. Preparations are going really well and Marie has every vase out and ready to make flower arrangements for all of the rooms in the house. What a vision, Marie.
Isn't it? My side of the table and this is your side of the table.
So now we're going to see, in this afternoon's cooking marathon, mm-hmm. who makes the most mess, aren't we?
Yes.
Uh-huh. It's not going to be me, is it?
No.
Wait, remove it from me.
Oh, Marie, have you been cooking with chocolate at all? It's hard for me to tell.
What?
Has some of it gone into the jars?
Yeah, and on my...
But it's going to be good, and it's no small thing to make chocolate mousse for 40 people.
Marie's famous chocolate mousse with a pineapple coulis and a crumble topping. The birthday buffet is finally ready with chicken and lemon tagine, sweet potato and apricot tagine, baba ganoush, hummus, all homemade. Time for Team Kitchen to celebrate. I'm not sure that Mikkel, our new volunteer, was expecting to do this during his time at Lalande.
Come back together. Have a good one.
Yeah.
And au revoir.
Au revoir. Safe journey home.
Thank you.
This is a very sad moment. We don't like it when people leave.
No.
Marie's feeling a bit peckish.
Stephanie.
Just a little bit hungry. It's actually getting expensive keeping her in pastry.
Yeah.
I've got what feels a little bit like a Marie Antoinette crisis today. What do I do with a mound of pastries? I think I'm going to make them into pain au chocolat pudding. Take something that's already fattening and make it more fattening.
I like the fact that we're doing this in style. And this is just a little something you've slipped into for watching Escape to the Chateau. Yeah.
I'm so glad that you got that dress.
Me too.
The colours are amazing on you.
I love it. Thank you so much. I felt a bit Egyptian today.
Cheers.
Cheers.
A wooden balcony would be more in keeping.
A decision this big.
You already agree with that.
So that is what it would be if we stick on the wrought iron.
Oh, something's burning!
No, I just checked, it's fine.
Oh, for Stephanie.
Oh, sorry.
Now I'm going to take you all back in time and show you some of the behind-the-scenes videos from the filming this summer.
Since clearing it out, they've put in fire bricks.
Does that mean somebody's lying in there?
Yes.
Truly, truly special.
Somebody was lying in there for days on end, and it was Walton, and he did a superb job.
Hello.
Well, come on in.
It looks so snug. Do you think this will be the warmest place to live in winter?
This is probably going to be the place.
Oh, great, we've got a sauna.
Gerald, do you want to talk me through today's outfit?
Yeah, well, this is what I normally wear. I thought I would just dress down a wee bit today.
Why do you have trousers on underneath your shorts?
Because Superman wears his underpants above his trousers.
Okay, good, good. So this
and
is...
And I think this is a time when somebody has got to make a stand. There's not many Super Marvel heroes left.
And God knows we need a Superman in this house.
You know, from now on, I want to be known as Scottman.
Yes. This is Mummy about to tackle the bread oven.
I need fresh air. Because I'm going into that dirty room. And it's filthy.
I just want to show everyone your safety footwear. I can't believe you're my mother.
No, I have my doubts personally too.
Mm. This is like a circus act.
It's getting up on my shoulders next.
Right. Yeah.
I'm putting up the curtains for the bed crown in my mother's apartment. And it's incredibly fiddly. And it's extreme curtaining because it has to be done really high up. And I should definitely have taken the heels off first.
Doesn't it look like the snuggest bed in the world?
There's no bed yet.
That's the only thing missing. It looks so good.
Back in the present day, I'm trying to launch a YouTube channel to have a home for all of my vlogs. This is where I want to spend the afternoon working, but I can't because our Wi-Fi is too bad, so instead I have to get in the car and hunt for 4G. At home, it would take 10 hours to upload a 15-minute vlog. Mary is now helping me push the car because here I was in my lovely little office doing the vlog and the car's broken down and I can't get home. We're moving it so that the farmer can get into his field.
Just a little bit harder, Mary. I'm sorry, I'm busy vlogging. So you're just going to have to do this. Oh my god. Marie, I was joking. I'm joining in.
Right, mobile office number one is now charging. So off to mobile office number two. Marie won't need the car for the next couple of hours. I'm well equipped in here with everything I need. There's no stopping me now. Well, I found a new spot with better 4G and much, much better company. 3 hours later, I'm still here, still trying to make a YouTube channel. Better go back for dinner now, though. I think they'll be wondering where I am.
I can't believe I don't get to watch Escape to the Chateau DIY with you today.
I know, but I tried to.
My car's broken down again. And I have to drive up north to go and visit Angel, and I don't want to miss that.
What if it happens tomorrow morning at the hotel? Oh, thank God. I'm leaving you the working car so that you're not stranded.
Thank you.
Wish me luck, though.
Good luck.
My worry now is that I'm getting really low on petrol, but I don't dare stop the car. It's a 4-hour journey, but if I stop, maybe it won't start again. It's absolutely extraordinary. It's a 4.5-hour drive to get to Dick and Angel's, and almost the entire way is just deserted country roads. It's a joy. I feel as though I've gone back in time.
My favourite part of the drive is through the ancient forest of Losh with its mysterious old obelisks. The four pyramids of the forest of Losh are all classified as historical monuments. They were built in the 1770s to help hunting parties find their way through the woods. Just forest for miles and miles. And then suddenly an 18th century obelisk. Unbelievably, this forest was once British. Henry II Plantagenet owned this land. Henry II had been at loggerheads with Thomas Becket, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and one day cried out, "Who will rid me of this troublesome priest?" Four knights took his words a bit too literally and murdered Thomas Becket at the altar of Canterbury Cathedral. Henry was very worried about what this would mean for his eternal soul, so decided to atone by building Carthusian monasteries. He gave a huge part of this forest to the monks. The Carthusian order of monks was founded by St. Bruno when he built his first hermitage in the Chartres Mountains in 1084. Throughout France, their monasteries take their names from those mountains and are all called Chartres. In England, they were called charter houses, presumably because charter was as close as the English could get to saying Chartreuse. They kept it until the Revolution. Today, the Chartreuse monks are best known for their liqueur, which they still make to the same recipe that they've been using since the 17th century. I finally arrived. We chateau owners don't get paid for taking part in Escape to the Chateau DIY, but the production company have put me up in a lovely hotel. Though this beautiful building had a dark start in life, it was built by a rich merchant in the 1770s, but he sadly lost his head in the revolution just 19 years later. Oof, thank goodness we live in happier chateau-owning times.
I decided not to let the fact that I'm on my own stop me from going to the nice restaurant downstairs. So I'm just going to go and style it out by myself at one of the tables.
No strings and no connections, no ties to my affections. I'm fancy free and free for anything fancy. No dates that can't be broken, no words that can't be spoken, especially when I am feeling romancy.
I've eaten so much I doubt I'll be able to drag my way up the stairs.
You know, the loveliest thing was that I didn't feel at all alone during that meal because I spent all the time in between my courses chatting to you all on the Escape to the Chateau DIY fan page. So thank you for that. It was a really lovely evening.
I'm nearly at Dick and Angel's now. I'm so excited. I love their place. I find it incredibly inspirational. I can't wait to see Angel. I'm sure she's going to have amazing ideas for me. What a stunning home. I love these fairy tale towers.
Let's go and explore the outside.
Let's go have fun. I can't film my vlog with Angel because we're busy filming the series, but what an amazing woman she is. We just had the most fantastic time.
This solution. Is how I always film my vlog.
The camera crew are trying to escape from my vlog.
If I had a camera to hide behind now, I would feel much more comfortable.
Mm-hmm. You're basically nude.
I feel very nude, especially in this open, expansive gravel field.
There's nowhere to get away. Hide.
Rafe, however, has no problem being on camera. More Brigadoon.
Yeah?
Yeah. And now Russian dancing.
You see?
Why aren't you on the show? Get a chateau.
Bloody good question, darling. Where's my chateau?
I had an amazing time with Angel and she's given me the most fantastic advice for an area that I'm doing at La Lande, which I can't talk about yet. As I'm up in the north, I'm taking the opportunity to stay with Michael and his lovely family at the Chateau de la Baminiere, and I'm nearly there now.
Sometimes I have to pinch myself that I actually get to stay in these homes.
Yay, where am I staying? I've never been in the main
you
house
are
before.
Staying in the green room.
The green one?
Yes.
No way!
Yeah.
This is my room.
Chartreuse liqueur on a Chartreuse green paint background. Mm. Did you plan this in advance, Michael? Did you know I'd be wanting to try Chartreuse today?
Yeah, it's all planned. Everything.
This recipe has apparently been used since the 17th century.
1605, it says there.
Well, well, let's try it. It's a great and slightly scary colour.
It's quite thick, actually.
It's like a potion.
It's like syrupy.
Cheers, Mr. Petherick. Good to see you again.
I am all sorted. I have my Chartreuse liqueur, and I will be reading The Chateau by Dick and Angel Strawbridge, which Angel gave to me today.